After spending a fortune on braces to straighten your teeth, you don't want that new beautiful smile to shift back to its original position. So orthodontists recommend wearing a retainer for several months after the braces come off to avoid any shifting. Oftentimes, an orthodontist advises their patients to wear a retainer for about a year after their braces are removed. Retainers are custom made for each person using a model of the patient's mouth. The orthodontist scans the patient's teeth and palate and sends the 3D images to a lab. A 3D printer builds each model by printing approximately 750 layers of material, which takes about 4.5 hours. The printer prints resin and a support material. The support material prevents the model from shifting during the printing process and provides structural support for the resin in complex areas. The support material is water-soluble. Once a model is printed, they soak it in water for 10 minutes, then remove the material with a pressure washer. A technician places the model in a vise. Using a preformed clasp made of stainless steel wire, she fits the wire around the first molar, bending it with pliers to fit snugly around the tooth. Then she bends the end in a specific shape. This step will help to anchor the wire in the retainer's acrylic palate at a later time. She clips off excess wire and repeats these steps for the opposite side. Once both clasps are in position, the technician secures them with sticky wax. Next, she assembles the front of the retainer called the labial bow. To do so, she bends a piece of wire against a form. Then she marks where to bend the wire to create an adjustment loop on each side. The labial bow is secured to the model with wax. Using a pulse welder, a technician tacks the labial bow and the clasps together. He applies flux, a chemical that preps an area for soldering. He also applies a heat shielding product to prevent the wires from overheating. Next, the labial bow is soldered to the clasp with a silver-based solder that's safe to wear. He steams off the wax, removes the finished retainer wire from the model, and polishes the solder joint. The retainer's palate is made of acrylic and comes in multiple colors. A technician waxes the wire onto the model, then applies the acrylic to the palate, embedding the ends of the wire. The acrylic is made up of liquid and powder, which react when mixed. She applies about 3 layers of each to the palate, producing an 1/8-inch thick mold. The excess acrylic is trimmed off with a knife. Then the model is placed into a pressure cooker for 10 minutes. The pressure removes air bubbles in the acrylic, while the heat speeds up the curing. When the acrylic is ready, the technician uses a steam gun to melt the wax holding the wire to the model. She removes the fully formed retainer off the model. She trims the acrylic with a grinding wheel to smooth out rough areas and refine the shape. With a hand tool, she smooths the entire surface so it won't irritate the patient's mouth. Another technician runs the acrylic palette against a muslin rag wheel with pumice, a natural abrasive. This makes the surface glossy. He applies a greaseless polishing compound to another muslin rag wheel and polishes the acrylic to a high shine. Finally, he drops the retainer into an ultrasonic cleaning machine containing mild acid. The combination of acid and sonic waves removes the pumice and polish residues. Once the retainer has been rinsed with water and dried, it's placed in a storage case. Now it's ready to be shipped to the orthodontist. No one knows who came up with the idea of squeezing oranges to make juice. The popularity of orange juice increased dramatically in the middle of the 20th century, as techniques were developed to extend its shelf life. Today, many people start their day with a tall glass of OJ. In its purest form, orange juice is fresh squeezed and made with no preservatives or other additives. The appeal is indisputable. Fresh squeezed OJ contains vitamin C, and the flavor is authentic. Orange juice production starts in groves. The trees take several months to bear fruit and are harvested in early November. Picking oranges is a job that's done entirely by hand. An automated picking system could damage both the trees and the fruit. The picker uses a bag made of vinyl composite that's lightweight and heavy duty. There are multiple types of juicing oranges. This one is called the Hamlin. Hamlin oranges are small and juicy. The trees they grow on are productive and resilient to cold. The picker plucks the fruit from the trees before they turn orange. They may be green on the outside, but they are still sweet on the inside. The fruit size and condition are indications of maturity and flavor. As the picker empties the bag into a bin, he examines the oranges. Anything with tears or punctures may also have internal degradation, but superficial flaws won't affect the quality of the juice. The oranges are taken to a processing facility and transferred to a sloped chute. The gradient of the chute prevents damage as the oranges tumble into a wash station. A sprayer sprays soapy water onto the oranges as spiraling nylon brushes scrub and clean while simultaneously moving them forward. After the wash, another sprayer rinses them off as the spiraling brushes continue scrubbing. The oranges transition to a roller conveyor that takes them up and under drying fans. As the oranges exit the dryer, an inspector checks them for any missed damage. The oranges travel across more revolving brushes. The bristles on these brushes are gentler than on the first group. They buff the skin of the fruit and remove any residual dirt. Finally, the oranges fall off the conveyor line into a bin. Now cleaned, the oranges can be juiced with no contaminants that could spoil either the product or juicing machinery. As a final precaution, the juicing operator performs one last inspection. If she's completely satisfied with their cleanliness and general condition, she loads the oranges into the extractor. There's no need to slice them beforehand. She feeds them to the juicing machine whole. The system feeds the oranges one at a time to the extractor. The extractor punctures the fruit and metal teeth peel away the skin. It squeezes out the juice while simultaneously filtering out the seeds and the membrane between the flesh of the orange and the skin. The juice flows into a vat. A screen in the vat filters the pulp to the desired consistency. There are several different filters for different amounts of pulp. The juice is bottled in jugs. The plastic jugs will accommodate any expansion of the unpasteurized juice due to fermentation. Instead of pasteurizing this fresh squeezed juice, it is chilled immediately. The unpasteurized orange juice won't have an extended shelf life, but the trade-off is an unaltered flavor and color. Refrigeration will preserve the juice for a few days. And after all, fresh squeezed orange juice is a drink that's best served cold.